Good morning, students. Today we will start with a new lesson, our environment for standard third. So students, you can see here the picture of the different things: bat, pot, cup and a reel. That is a cotton reel which you must have seen your mother stitching. The next is the picture of the fruits. So all these things makes the surrounding. See the new picture of the monkey and the trees, mountains, rivers, houses. So all these things makes the environment. The things which around us makes the environment. So in the environment, what do you see? Stone, rock, soil, rivers, streams, lakes, airs, mountains, even jungles, fields, houses, roads. All these things makes the environment. And we too are part of the environment. Now next is a sparrow and a roadside stone. What is the difference between the sparrow and the roadside stone? Now sparrow is a living thing. It lays eggs and it builds nest on the trees and it search food for its young ones. It collects the insects and grains, and the sparrow hatch their eggs. So, and the stone, it is a non-living thing. It just lays on the roadside. There is no life in the stone. So, this is the difference between the living and the non-living things. The sparrow is a living thing and the stone is a non-living thing. Now, we will see the two groups, living and the non-living things. Now, living things are of two kinds, plants and animals. Now animals, they have the babies. They look after the babies and they give birth to the babies and they care for the babies. Even the plants, they also look after the seedlings. The seedlings grow into a big plant. So plants and the animals, there are two kinds of plants and animals, living and the living things. The plants need water, the plants require water, and then they grow into flowers and fruits. So plant is also a living thing and an animal is also a living thing. The difference between this is the animals move from one place to another, but the plants, they stand at one place and grow. So this is the difference between this living things, plants and animals. The next is, are these things in the picture living or non-living? Now you can make out from this picture which are the living and the non-living. Now this plant, they are still at one place. So this is a living thing. They grow the fruits. And these are non-living. The gas, the glass and the kadai, they are still at one place. So it is a non-living thing. So this is the difference between the living and the non-living thing. The relationship between all these things in the environment. Now water and air are part of the environment. All living things need them. Now plants also require the air and the animals also require the air. So all these things are the part of the environment. Whatever living things need to survive, they need to get from the environment. Now the living things, they survive due to the environment. If there is no rain, if there is no water, the plants, they are no more. They will dry. Even the living things like the birds, they also cannot live without the environment, that is the air and water. So these are the part of the environment. Human beings also depend on the environment. Now you can see here the picture of the cotton. With the cotton, the clothes are made. The wool is made from the sheep. The sheep gives wool, and then the paper and this basket is made from the plants, that is the wood. So all the human beings, they also depend on the environment. Even the medicinal herbs are also from the environment. The seeds of some plants are scattered by the wind. So plants sometimes are scattered. They are growing in many places. How it is possible? Because sometimes the seedlings, the seed of the plants are taken away by the animals or the birds and they throw in different places. In this way, the plants grow in different places. Living things take many things from the environment. What effect does that have on the environment? Now, just like the living things take the things from the environment also takes some things from the living things. Now, you can see the animals like vulture and foxes, they eat the flesh of the dead animals. In this way, they clean the environment. Similarly, the environment also takes some things from the dead animals. The dead animals, they decay and then they mix with the soil. The leaves also, dry leaves fall and they get mixed in the soil. In this way, the soil gets fertile and the plants get nourishment. So plants also grow from this soil. So plants, the environment also take something from the living things, that is the animals and the birds, and the animals also take some things from the environment. So does living things bring about changes in non-living things also? So living things and non-living things, they both depend on the environment. So the next picture is the ship. The body of the ship is covered with the wool. The ship feeds on the leaves of the shrubs. So you can see the seeds of some plants get stuck on the body of the ship. Why this happens? Because the ship wanders in the plants and the shrubs and bushes, and they carry the seeds with them, and then the seeds fall in different places and then the plants grow. So in this way, the ship, which is an animal, and the shrub, which is a plant, help each other. So in this way, the living things and the non-living things both depend on each other. The plants, the environment also depend on the living and things, and the living things also depend on the environment. So this is a lesson on environment. Now what we have to learn from this environment? The main topic is there are many things in our environment. Some are of them are living things and some are non-living things. Living things can move on their own. So living things, that is the animals and the birds, they move here and there in search of the food. Living things need food. Yes, living things, that is the birds and animals, they search food. We human beings also depend on the environment for the food. Living things produce young ones like themselves. Living things give birth to the young ones. Living things are of two kinds, plants and animals. Living things get all that they need from their environment. So living things get from the environment, the main important is the air and the water, which they get from the environment. Living things bring about changes in non-living things too. Just like the living things depend on the environment for water and air, the non-living things also depend on the living things. Like the example, the decay of the dead animals, the dry leaves, they fall in the soil and then they get mixed in the soil, and then the new the soil become fertile and the new plant is grown. So in this way, the non-living things also bring changes on the living things. All things on in the environment depend on each other. All the things, that is living and non-living things, depend on each other. So this was the lesson for standard third, the environment.